Hey everyone, it's Aaron here and you're watching the PDFelement YouTube channel. Today I've got some great news to share with you. The long-awaited PDF measure tool has just been released. So do you need to add measurements before printing your professional drawings? Well, now you can use the new PDF measurement tool built right into PDFelement to measure area, distance, and perimeter with ease. So let's take a closer look. Hello everyone, welcome back. It's time to learn some new skills with PDFelement. So recently we've had many users asking about how to add measurements to their drawings and images. For example, I'm a builder and I'd like to measure a plan and find out dimensions according to the scale of the drawing. Is it possible? What's the best way to measure lines in a drawing? How do I save time measuring drawings with accurate ruler scalings? Could we fill with color in a measured area? Can you measure the distance between two points in PDFelement? I can modify the size using the buttons on the image. However, is there a measurement tool that I can use to make it a specific size? And is there a tool that allows me to measure length areas with a scaled architectural drawing? Whew. Oh my God, so many professional questions and I'm not sure I can really answer them. Just kidding. If you're looking for answers, you're in the right place. So don't worry, whether you are a CAD designer, a construction industry worker, such as an architect, engineers and refined control designer, or regular users who just need to check sizes regularly, like students and professionals. Well, in this video, we're going to show you how to measure your drawings and plans in PDFelement step by step. So you can end up with a measured image like this one. So let's go. Now, this will be a slightly longer video than usual, but I promise you it will be very valuable. So grab a hot drink, sit comfortable and get ready to take some notes and make sure to watch. So firstly, let's get to know some basic knowledge of the PDF measure tool. This is our all new tool, which was developed on PDFelement for Windows, a feature that supports measurements in PDF files. So you can use this tool to measure drawings and areas of objects. So let's talk about the three modes of measuring. So firstly, we have distance. So using this icon allows you to measure the distance between two points. Simply click at a point and drag your mouse to the second point and click again to get the result. You'll see the measurement move as you move your mouse back and forth. And you can also create these vertical lines by clicking after and dragging your mouse up and down. Now, if you want to measure perimeter, use this icon, which will allow you to measure a set of distances between multiple points. Just click each point you want to measure, then double click the final point. It will automatically snap if you complete the shape like this, for example. To measure area, choose this icon. This allows you to measure the area within the line segments that you draw. So simply click the first point and the second point and you will see a line. Then click the third point and it becomes a triangle, and again a fourth point to become a polygon. Now you can continue clicking to create further points to measure specific shapes. In these actions of continuous clicking, you can complete the area measurement and simply double click to finish. Now for some quick fire tips. So tip one, you'll find there are a few differences between PDFelement's area measurement and competing products. So it uses a polygonal absorption measurement method, which greatly facilitates the user to better accurately select and measure within the area. Unlike other PDF measurement tools on the market, which still measure using the line method. So you'll find that it's way more accurate using PDFelement. And tip two, well, yes, PDFelement's measurement tool provides some friendly arrow and line designs for different measuring and drawing needs. So you can personalize it to suit what you need. Simply right click, choose properties, and you can change the appearance of the start, the end, and also the style of the line itself. Select the thickness, as well as the fill and line color and opacity. Now let's check out how you can adjust the measure settings. This will cover how to change the unit, scale ratio, and change label. To do this, simply right-click and select measure settings, which is where you will find the scale ratio, snap, and label. You will also find all of the different units needed in most situations in the scale ratio drop-down menu. Now, these are usually features used by professionals, but in order to help our users use these features more easily and smoothly, PDFelement provides a more user-friendly snap mode design. So there are four snap modes to help you align accurately during the measuring process. Now, the default setting is to have all four selected, but depending on your specific needs, you may only want one or a combination of some of these for your specific measuring process. So let's take a more detailed look at this. So with a line path, that helps you to automatically locate a line segment and then snap a certain line segment closely. So it looks like a small box when you process this measurement. Now, a line endpoint helps you close to the endpoint automatically locate the endpoint and is displayed as a small circle. A line midpoint helps you to close to the midpoint, automatically locate the midpoint, and displays it as a small triangle. And a line intersection helps you close to an intersection point to automatically locate the intersection point and displays it with a small cross. Well, I think you have a pretty good overview now of the PDFelement measurement tool, so let's put these into practice right now. So using a sample, we're going to show you how to measure the area of a floor plan. First, if you haven't done so already, make sure to download PDFelement for Windows. Now I'll jump onto the computer and show you how it's done. So once you have it installed and open, you need to go over to the comment section here, and you'll find the new measuring tools right here. And opened up, we have a PDF file of a floor plan for a house. So step one is to calibrate the drawing. So I'm going to zoom in on the scale of this image. And we actually want this to be 1/4 inch per foot. So we can right click once you have one of these tools selected and go to measure settings. And you can see here under the scale ratio, it's 1 centimeter for every meter. So we're gonna change this to 1/4 inch. So 0.25 inch to 1 foot. Then click OK. Now all of our measurements will be configured to this scale ratio. So step two is to measure the area of a floor plan. So let's just zoom in a little bit more and select our measuring tool once again. Now in this instance, we can measure the linear distance, a perimeter, or even an area. So let's choose the area tool as our example for this one. Let's say we want to measure the area of this room. Simply begin plotting your measuring points. And as I travel with my cursor, you'll see that the measurement begins to work. And the small circle button, which means we've successfully found an endpoint correctly. You'll see the shape becomes a circle again once it's found another endpoint. You could actually continue onwards to create more complex shapes if you need it to. So we'll double click to finish. As well as double clicking, you can also right click and choose measurement completed. If you make any mistakes during the process, you can right click and choose measurement cancel, or you can also hit escape on your keyboard. So quick tip, as we introduced before, in this measuring process, you'll find some different snap icons. So a small circle, a small box, and a small triangle. All of them are for helping the snap process to be more precise and to align to each point. Depending on your specific needs and area of expertise, you can choose and cancel specifics by going to the measure settings and choosing your required snap points. So now I want to show you how you can actually highlight measurements. So once you have a completed measurement, simply hit right click and go to properties. That will open up the properties tab on the right side here. And we can add shading to our measurement area with the fill color. Let's say we'll make it blue. And this will make the measured area highlight and stand out more. We can also actually adjust the border color. For example, let's make it purple, as well as the style of the line and the thickness of the line as well. Right, so now we've almost finished. So the last step is to check the measurement result. So this is obviously the most important thing, but there are 4 ways to actually check the result. Number one is real-time show. So the easiest and most intuitive way is simply to move the cursor to the area that's been measured, and you'll see the measurement pop up and displayed like so. Number two is under the actual comment list. So if you go over to the comment list over here, click on comment, you'll see a list of actions that's been done to this file, and you'll see every measurement made in the document listed right here. So you'll see here the results of our measurement. Number three is to open up a pop-up note. So click on the area that you've completed the measurement tool on, and you'll see the measurement result on the actual pop-up note itself. This is actually handy, so if you add anything to the label, it'll come here, and you can also change the color of it as well. And the final method is to simply click on your finished measurement. So right click, and then click on properties, and under the properties tab under measurement result, you'll see the result here of the measurement,
And it also very handily shows you the scale ratio as well.
Okay, so did you learn all that? We've covered quite a lot in this video, but as you saw, it was pretty much a piece of cake to do. You'll find that the measurement tool is a really useful feature for a range of different scenarios. For example, if you need to know the precise size of an image file and make adjustments, here's a greeting card that I want to print, and I can simply use the distance tool to check the size. I can even set the measuring interval for specific objects within the greeting card like this.
You can also use the measuring tool to make sure that objects are, for example, the exact same length in your files, to check for things like consistency, as well as to check the interval between objects, again, to check for consistency. So this is really useful for graphic design, architects, designers, pretty much lots of different use cases.
So as you can see, you can achieve quite a lot of things using these tools. However, in this video, we've only just scratched the surface, but if you still have more questions or other scenarios for these tools, well, don't hesitate to comment below and let us know. We'll definitely consider making more videos about this topic. Due to the measuring tool being our 1.0 version, our product team will be updating and adding more components very soon. Anyways, comment below and let us know what you think and what you'd like to see in the future. The PDFelement team is here for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I guess I'll see you next time. Don't forget to like this video, and if you found it helpful, hit subscribe to see more. Thank you very much. Bye.